world has had many great walls. Vietnam Veterans Memorial Wall, Adrian's Wall in Rome. According to the NBADraft.net, John Wall is pretty great. the Great Wall of China. But we've also had many bad walls. There's a history of division. They tear apart families. They discourage unity. And sometimes they even prevent escape from oppressive regimes, such as the Berlin Wall. This is the North and South Korea border. It prevents defectors from the totalitarian North from escaping to the South and reuniting with their families. There's also the Berlin Wall, which famously separated the East Bloc from the West Bloc and prevented defectors from the Communist East. And according to the Washington Post, the number of walls separating countries has increased dramatically since the fall of the Berlin Wall and since 9/11. The world doesn't need more walls. So why does Donald Trump want to build another one? If you haven't heard, Donald Trump has a plan to build a wall spanning 1,954 miles that separates the US and Mexico. I've been following the presidential campaign for months now. Since it's my first year voting, I feel like it's a civic duty to become educated and to learn about each of the candidates so that I make an educated choice when I vote. I try to see every candidate's policies with an unbiased view, but one candidate in particular keeps promising things that doesn't make sense and are not feasible, and sometimes they're even immoral. Of all of Trump's policies, the wall is one of the most ridiculous. Today, I'll address the economic, moral, and logical reasons why even thinking of building such a wall is a bad idea. So first, the economics of this wall. According to CNN, the wall will cost about $15 million per mile, and the border is 1,954 miles. This works out to about $30 billion. According to the U.S. Office of Management and Budget, that's about equal to the budget of our country's entire science program. So besides the staggering initial cost, there's also the cost of maintenance and paying the Border Patrol. So how would this huge cost be paid for? Higher taxes? Well, according to Donald Trump, Mexico will pay for the wall. But former Mexican President Vicente Fox says, Mexico, quote, will not pay for that effing wall. So, besides the cost of the wall, undocumented workers still pay taxes. They pay about $12 billion in taxes every year. And according to the New York Times, they contribute $15 billion to Social Security annually, but only take out about $1 billion. So immigrants are good for the economy. It's not worth it to keep them out. And deporting them is even costlier, but I won't get into that. The costs of that. But I will get into the morals of that. So, the complementary policies with the wall is that he wants to deport all 11.1 million undocumented workers in the United States. I get that number from the Pew Research Center. And that's immoral because they have families here. 86% of illegal immigrants have been in the US for over 7 years, according to the Fiscal Times. They've worked hard to build lives, and sometimes they've even literally built this country. America is the land of immigrants. We're literally all immigrants, aside from Native Americans. So it's just plainly immoral to tear families apart and deport people back to Mexico. The wall will also damage US and Mexico relationships. Without even building the wall yet, just the idea of it has changed the way that Mexicans and Americans view each other. It's inspired hate, divisiveness, and even xenophobia. And this policy happens all while the US and Canada border is completely open, which which inspires racism. The third point I'd like to make is the logic of building such a wall. The landscape has rivers, mountains, and private land, which makes the legal and logistical issues of building a wall arise. And that will also make it very difficult to create in a timely manner. PolitiFact says that 40% of illegal immigrants enter with legal visas. It's just that they overstay their visas. So building this wall won't prevent illegal immigrants from entering the country. Many others also come from using forged documents or are smuggled through checkpoints along the border. So basically, the wall would be useless. Our border is already secure. We have border control across the Mexican-American border. So the wall basically is pointless. So in conclusion, Donald Trump says that the wall will keep out rapists and murderers. But really, it'll just keep out hard workers who want to make a life for themselves and their families. So I'm not asking you to not vote for Donald Trump. I'm not asking you to vote for Bernie Sanders or Hillary Clinton or Marco Rubio. I just implore you to educate yourselves on the candidates and to get out there and vote and to make the right decision. Because we can make America great again, but this isn't the way to do it.